What's up, Peep Squad? Peep Squad is in the building, baby. Please like, comment, subscribe, share the video. It'll be greatly appreciated. Let's get into the situation. Let's talk about Miss Wendy Williams, and there's a whole lot going on. And also, let's talk about Kevin Hunter. It seems like he's taking some shots out here at Wendy Williams, or is he gloating? Let's just talk about it. But in any event, let's get down to the situation. So allegedly, the U.S. Sun basically is reporting that Wendy Williams is in some need of some serious help, because they are basically saying that Wendy Williams has been drinking every single day. You know, like, she has been drinking every day. Every day is a whole lot. There's a whole lot on your body. There's a whole lot on your blood pressure, you know, your heart, everything, your kidneys, your liver, everything. And then on top of that, you know, Wendy has some underlying health issues too as well. So I'm pretty sure alcohol is not good for her. But in any event, it is going down. And they are basically reporting that that's why she had to go get a 5150. She had to get some psychiatric help because, you know, maybe she was in a drunken stupor and basically just went off. Just went, you know, berserk. Like, that is a crazy situation. And as you know, the Sun is reporting this on September 20th. But I believe Tasha K, you know, she came out Friday and she basically alleged that Wendy Williams is in rehab and she was in a drunken stupor and a psychiatric type of stupor, that she was, you know, out of her mind because of alcohol. And now it seems like Monday, all the blogs are reporting that Wendy Williams is suffering from issues according to alcohol and other things. So she might just be in rehab. But in any event, Wendy Williams is still being taken care of and looked after. Her brother did give us some, you know, information, said that he's spoken to his sister and she seems to be okay. But this is a battle that she's going to have to fight on her own. And not too many people win this battle. So basically, he didn't seem like he was up in high hopes with the situation. But in any event, you know, it's been reported that Wendy is drinking way too much and she's drinking every day. She's been drinking while filming. That's what the insider told The Sun, basically saying this is one of the reasons why her season premiere was pushed back and she couldn't do promotion because she was in a drunken stupor. She, you know, she probably wasn't able to work. She probably wasn't able to do the things that she normally does because alcohol makes you sometimes psychotic and you can get amnesia and lose things and forget things and just be paranoid at the same time. So this is probably what makes sense, that, you know, they had the rescue squad, they had the firemen, and they had the police at Wendy Williams' house to take her into, you know, a 5150, and hopefully she gets the help that she needs. But also, it's being alleged that the staffers at, you know, the Wendy Williams show, they know exactly what's going on. They actually are, allegedly, they told The Sun that they smell alcohol on Wendy. She comes in there drunk and things of that nature. And they're saying basically she smells like a booze fest. Like, that's a whole lot to say about somebody. So that means the situation was really bad. That means them demons and them things that Wendy Williams is going through, losing her mother, you know, Kevin Hunter, and just all the backlash she has been receiving and just trying to put on a face for people like everything's okay. But in the inside, it ain't okay, because she doesn't like, you know, where she's at today, you know. She doesn't like that she can't walk, you know, a block, or she has to, you know, use a wheelchair. And then also, it's reporting that Wendy Williams doesn't have many friends or many people that she can lean on at this time. And as you guys know, it's been reported, you know, a while ago, that when it comes to Wendy Williams, when she was married to Kevin for 21 years, that, you know, he kept her away from everybody. She didn't have a lot of associates, a lot of friends. She didn't have time to hang out. She didn't have time to do this because, you know, basically she came home from work and stayed there and basically was with Kevin. That was her life. Now that whole life has changed. She's home alone. And this is what reports are saying, and people are saying to The Sun, that basically Wendy Williams is lonely. You know, she had her life planned out in a certain way and it did not end that way. It ended tragic when it came to her losing her husband and that public embarrassment. But in any event, It's like, come on, Wendy, we want you to move on. We want you to get through this situation. We want you to show us and show the people that many years you was giving advice about relationship, dump him, leave him, move on, who cares? Be by yourself. You know, you might as well be happy. You know, you might as well be alone and be happy than to be miserable and be with somebody else. And you know what I mean? You exude that, and then it's just shocking that you are suffering just like the rest of the women that you report on suffer too, and keep going back and forth. But at the same time, like, we think that there's some extra strength, some extra power in you, Wendy, that you are, you know, you can be superwoman. And we hope that she actually comes through this situation, and, you know, hopefully there's not a lot of brain damage done, there's not a lot of damage to her body and things of that nature where it gets even worse for her. We don't want that to happen. So make sure you guys lift up Wendy Williams in prayer, because baby, Kevin Hunter done moved on. He done got himself a new woman, Sharina Hudson, and she was been in the picture for a long time. That shit gotta hurt too as well, knowing that your husband spent at least 10 years with this woman, you know, now he ended up with her and they do have a baby, and he started all over raising a new family, and she doesn't have that. She don't have someone to start over new. I don't know if she's capable of it, but she can just be happy and be healthy and basically just change. Maybe she can be, you know, a superhero for women that, hey, listen, you may go through all these bad, you know, triumphant situations, get dogged out, you may get older and you don't feel like you are beautiful enough, or you may be insecure, but I did it, you know, something like that. And people will encourage her on, and I believe that will help her with the strength. But also, you know, losing her mother, like, that ain't no, you know, joke too as well. You know, her mother comforted her. But in any event, we got Kevin Hunter. He's out here in these streets and he is celebrating and he is having a good time and he's living his life. He was out here partying on the weekend and he was celebrating his birthday and he was out there having drinks. He was just being so happy. Baby. And any event, Kevin Hunter also posted to Instagram that birthday vibes all week, you know, basically saying he's so strong, and he said he's so thankful to the Most High God for all blessings. You know, he's been blessed. He definitely has, from Brownsville to where he's at today and where he's been with Wendy Williams. Hell yeah, he is blessed. And also he says, I tried to tell him. Then he also says health is wealth. So is that a shot at Wendy Williams? Is he saying that he tried to tell Wendy that health is wealth? You know what I mean? Is he basically saying, oh, I told you so? Like, she don't need I told you so. She need a miracle. She need prayer. She needs help. She needs love. She needs support. She needs all that. Not I told you so. We all know that. But in any event, you know, Kevin Hunter continues to say, not money. God said they will learn. Have a blessed day. So he's basically saying health is wealth, not money. So he's saying that, oh, since Wendy Williams got all the money, she done cashed out, she done got everything, you know, but something that she worked hard for and she put herself on a line for and she sacrificed and she had to get on that radio station and she had to get in front of TV. She had to do the interviews. She had to act like everything was okay when she was going through hell inside. You know what I mean? She worked for that money. She sweated for that money. You know, she said a lot of different things about people and created a lot of different enemies where she didn't even feel comfortable going out there in the streets and being around celebrities because she felt like they were going to come for her and get her. We heard Toto came through, but Kevin came through too as well. But in any event, so it seems like, you know, Kevin Hunter is taking a shot. So basically he's saying health is wealth, not money. And that could be a general statement that people will tell you. And I have said it over and over, you know, health is money, you know. You know what I mean? Because without health, you can't make money. And as we see, we don't see Wendy Williams on TV yet. And she does have a lot of money. But right now, she's not able to do something that she wants to do. And that's premiere season 13, I believe, of her Wendy Williams show, her syndicated show. And basically, she has gotten awards for that show. She's a one-woman show with the rest of the cast. But in any event, we got Kevin Hunter basically saying, health is wealth, not money. God said they will learn. Have a blessed day. So to me, it seems like he's taking a shot at Wendy Williams. And is he, you know, thinking that, oh, if something does happen to Wendy, her son is going to get all the money, then therefore if their son get all the money, you know, Kevin Hunter Jr., that means Kevin Hunter is going to be wealthy. So at this point, does he need Wendy to be alive to, you know, maintain? So you guys let me know what you think about this situation. I was like, Lord have mercy, what is going on? And Kevin out here living his life, celebrating his birthday, doing everything that he want to do, how he want to do it. And he just basically moved on. He got a whole new life. And it doesn't include Wendy. We just want Wendy to get strong. We want Wendy to come back. We want Wendy to come back 10 times as harder and stronger and more brilliant and more resilient. And also, we want Wendy Williams to show the strength and the power that she was raised with, and the strength and the power that she had to be a Black woman to, you know, make it to the top in this industry when it comes to radio, when it comes to TV, and when it comes to, you know, biopics and documentaries, and breaking people as far as music, you know, and putting people on as well to bring that strength back, to bring that power back, to show the haters that, baby, I may talk my shit, but I'm about it too as well, and keep it moving. You know, take the embarrassment out, take all the hurt out, take out the pain, just build up your strength, because that should make you stronger to not let, you know, Kevin get the best of you, or Serena Huston, how they was behind your back, sleeping together, you know, creating a life for themselves, funneling money from you, taking money from you, laundering money from you, allegedly. So, baby, in any event, Wendy, you need to come back. You need to show them who you are. You need to show them that this is the woman that got to where she's at today because she's strong, because she's a fighter, not a giver upper. You know what I mean? Not, you know, don't medicate yourself, allegedly. So basically, they're saying that Wendy has been drinking every single day. They said the only time that Wendy Williams was actually clean was when she was in a sober house. You remember when she had to tell us that she had to go to a sober house and she was out there in the woods? But in any event, they're saying that's the only time that she was clean. They said after that, like, she came back to work and she was a complete drunk. And if she was drinking all that time and nobody said nothing, nobody stopped her, you know, the people didn't come down and say, hey, listen, you got to do something. You know, that's a bad situation, because we don't know how much damage that she has done to her body. And she's very a frail woman, like, she's a skinny woman, you know, and she already has underlying issues. So in any event, you know, people are calling Wendy Williams staffers enablers. And we also heard Howard Stern say this a few years ago when him and Wendy Williams were beefing. And he said, that's why your staff is scared of you guys, because, you know, Wendy's over there doing this and doing that. And so he was alluding to, you know, her being, you know, erratic at work, and allegedly because of drugs. But Howard Stern and Wendy Williams did make up in that situation. So I'm like, Lord have mercy, what is going on? And it was, and she's been drinking too much, and they said that, you know, she's just been struggling after her divorce with Kevin Hunter. Like, it's been a struggle, like, she's heartbroken. And, you know, it's the worst feeling in the world when you're heartbroken and you think that you can't go on no more, and you rather give up on you. You rather give up on your life because, you know, someone that you thought you was going to spend the rest of your life with, you know, left you. But I believe Wendy believes in death do us part at this time with Kevin Hunter, because she's been married before. Because you see, you know, her mother had passed away and her father was still there with her mother. To death do us part. That's what she wanted with Kevin Hunter. And baby, it wasn't going to happen because Serena Huston that came in and did what it did. And it's also saying that sources are very concerned at the Wendy Williams show. And, you know, they are just very afraid to speak up, or very afraid to say anything, because they don't want to lose their jobs and things of that nature. And, you know, now, you know, you should have spoke up. I know you're scared, but look, you're not working right now, and you don't know when you're going to be working. So if you guys would have nipped this shit in the butt and basically refused to film or gather together and basically did something, you know, Wendy Williams can't replace you all, and she don't want no new faces around her. You know, she only want old faces. You force her to get help. And then in any event, you wouldn't have, it might be the same situation. But we'll see. And it says that Wendy is just really struggling. Page Six reported that Wendy Williams is just really struggling, being lonely and having these health issues. And you got Kevin Hunter out here basically saying health is wealth, baby. And he's out here basically saying not money. So I guess he thinks that he should have got more of Wendy Williams' money. I guess he wanted to walk away with more money from her. I know he put his work in and Blase in the third. But baby, you was a camel that broke the mother effing back of whores. And we just need Wendy Williams to repair her back, glue it back together, stick it back together, heal it back together, get some steroids, I don't know, but build your back up, Wendy. And in any event, you guys let me know what you think. Peace and love to all my peeps and my peoples. Peep Squad is in the building.